oil feed to the main bearings. Through those. Can you see how it works? It's actually bolts underneath. It goes through the mains like that.
Okay.
And then you feed it either side. I made it in case I, which side I could feed it from, you know?
Yeah.
Can you see that?
Yeah.
I made a second
one. Because you had to
drill holes.
I didn't know if
case.
You were going to do it through the engine cases or make something separate go into them.
Separate. Because I needed to get it exactly where I wanted without it interfering with the... with either side. You know what the problem with the sides is? The gears have to come out for the to drive the clutch.
Yeah.
And the other side, alternator and the starter motor.
Yeah.
So this way, it doesn't interfere with any of them. It actually, one fits underneath where there's nothing driving.
Yeah.
And the other one's on top of the other engine. You see that?
Yeah.
You have to think of these things, you know? I have to think like 100 engineers.
Yeah, because even though it's four YZF600 engines, it's only two crankshafts.
That's it.
Yep.
And the cranks are done, eh? Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
They've been made. So, what can you see? Can you see why I need another cylinder and four rods? I made a mistake, just like I did with the V12. I don't know what it is about me. I'm sitting there so frightened of having them too tight, made them too loose. And you've got to be careful of too loose. It says in the book, no more than 10 thou
gears.
I made it 20. I don't know why I do that. Only on four rods. So the guy can help us out with four rods, a cylinder, pistons, and a crank.
And if he has to mail
them... If it's a damaged crank, it doesn't matter. As long as the sprocket's good.
Yeah, just need the sprocket off the center.
And maybe you can pick it up for me.
Yeah.
Whoa. And if he wants too much for the crank...